So once again, good afternoon. I came here to discuss about digital image processing, which is the crux of remote sensing. Okay. So before going in depth with our lecture, let me tell some other things in this fashion about the organization. Already you people may be knowing, like our ISRO is being work directly under our Prime Minister, followed by under this Space Commission, this particular PRL, NARL, Northeast Space Application Center, which is dedicatedly working for seven sisters, in the sense Assam, Meghalaya, those Northeast states. Similarly, Semiconductor Laboratory, which is there in Chandigarh, is also coming under ISRO. And finally, IIST, Indian Institute of Space Technology, which is offering BTech courses. And usually, where the students are doing the BTech engineering in the fields of avionics, electronics, we used to observe again. So that they are like fine-tuning for ISRO's requirement. Okay? It's like a university, a space university, dedicated space university. Then, that side, if you are seeing Antrix is there, it's a commercial wing of ISRO. Because usually, ISRO is not to mint money from public or even interministerial projects. But if any money component is coming, assume last time Google requested ISRO to send a mini satellite. At the time, some component, money component used to come. Such type of commercial things will be dealt by Antrix. Okay? Then under ISRO, you can see VSS is there, Liquid Propulsion System Center is there, and Sriharikota SDH is there, ISAG, ISRO Satellite Center is there, Space Application Center is in Ahmedabad, and NRSC is there in Hyderabad. Okay. Extensively, the Space Application Center and NRSC, we used to deal with the GIS and remote sensing. Now, again, under that, lot of institutes are there, but under NRSC, under the directorate of NRSC, this many wings are there. Okay. Starting from left, it is like deputy directors will be there, where the first one is data reception, means that particular deputy director is responsible to receive the data from the satellites. The next division is data processing division, then next remote sensing applications, where whatever the theme you people are doing, like our theme is medicinal plants. We used to help you people. Some people may be working in forestry, some may be in environmental, some urban, some roads, all these things, those particular customized projects will be done by this RSSA, Remote Sensing Applications Area. Then comes ECSA, fourth one, from left side it's fourth one. It is actually Earth Climate and scientific applications area. Okay, like you can see nowadays lot of applications are there related to global warming. So all such type of projects, and even carbon emission, all these projects are being done by that particular area. Then one more interesting sector is this regional centers. Okay, the objective of these regional centers are to encourage state remote sensing centers. The first one is establishing the state remote sensing centers. 5 to 6 years back itself, almost all the states are having state remote sensing centers. They were incorporated with the help of this regional center concept itself. Like assume I used to tell you that Jodhpur, one regional remote sensing center is there. They used to help Rajasthan state remote sensing center, Punjab, Haryana, like this. So assume Bangalore, one regional remote sensing center is there. They used to help Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. Okay, anyway, Tamil Nadu is not having state remote sensing center. Anna University is taking care like that. And similarly, see, remote sensing in the sense, always we may not able to acquire data using satellites. Sometimes we may acquire data using flights. That particular thing we used to deal by this general manager, aerial services. Okay, ASDMA. Then one controller used to be there, who is like AS cadre, then followed by program planning and establishment group. Okay, it's like reaching the outreach division. And finally, for everything, there should be a quality parameter. So that particular group head, system reliability and quality assurance department will be dealing. So this is the structure of National Remote Sensing Center. Now, again, under National Remote Sensing Center, I told you, data reception deputy director is there, who is responsible to receive the data. This particular image you are seeing belongs to Earth NRSA near Shahnagar. We are having a good facility called Integrated Multi-Mission Ground Segment for Earth Observation Satellite, abbreviated as AMAGEOS. It's a complete automatic system where we can retrieve or receive data directly from the satellites. I just rounded off some four circles, right? They are antennas. They are antennas. And just see from the left side, third antenna ka upar ek black and white strips jaisa hai. That is like Kalwal site. Okay, after a couple of, or whenever a new satellite is launched, or assume after 6 months, or in a periodical way, we used to calibrate that particular sensor. Okay, because all the characteristics of Kalwal site are known to us, so camera will be focused there and we will recalibrate, so that any sensor defects are there will be nullified. Okay, and this particular building is like ISO standard building. There is no need of any electricity, light and natural air will be coming in that fashion. We are having a data center also, very big data centers. Yeah, and in fact, we are having mini antennas are also in this fashion. We used to take data from foreign satellites, wherever I am rotating the mouse. Okay, not only the major antennas, but we are having other minor antennas also. This is NRSA building, you can see here, from here we used to go like this, and this part is HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, and left to that is the NRSA, okay. And in NRSA, as I told, multiple disciplinary activities will be happening. Now comes the data processing unit. We are completed with the data reception, this thing. Now the, now comes data processing division. Under this one highlighted segment is Bhuvan. We will come to learn about Bhuvan at the later stage. And similarly, this data processing people will be doing all sorts of core data processing. Okay, we used to have a lot of advanced softwares, data center itself, okay, and some value added products, followed by some special products. If anybody wants data, they can tell boss, we please process in this particular fashion, they will able to do that particular processing. Now, why we are discussing all these things is this fellow, NRSC data center. Because of this only, last 10 slides I have to show. This NRSC data center is responsible to sell the data. What data? Satellite data, imagery, okay. That is the reason all this blah blah has been discussed, okay. This NRSC data center used to sell all this sort of data, like high resolution data, CartoSat 2, CartoSat 1, RESAT, microwave data followed by ResearchSat 1 and 2 data, and medium resolution data like LIS, AVIFS, and low resolution like OceanSat and OCM. Okay. So, you people have to approach this so-called NDC, NRSC data center, to acquire the data. Okay. Not only Indian satellite, but also foreign satellites also, you are bound to buy from NRSA only. That is the law. That is law. You cannot just go and buy data because of security measures. In India, even foreign satellites, like you can see here, most frequently like real estate people and those people will be using Iconos, QuickBoard, because they are 0.25 meters. Means, every 0.25 by 25 square will be recorded by the sensor, and the high degree of clarity will be there. Okay, so if you want to buy this data, again we have to reach this NDC people. So dedicatedly some 20 people may be there who will assist you. In fact, assume if you people want to buy, you can make a phone call, you can ask, I am having a project like this, which data I have to use. They will guide you in a systematic manner. So, for intra-government projects, there may be some negotiable cost, okay. But in general, for public, you can see like mono, okay, panchromatic CartoSat 2, mono georeference set is telling 2440 rupees, and ortho-corrected, they are telling 2890. I just raised my voice, ortho-corrected, we will see later. Similarly, panchromatic of CartoSat 1, aft and fore, means they, it may have two cameras, that's why. One is aft camera, one is fore camera. Okay, they are telling if you take georeference kit, it will be 4450. Stereo ortho kit, it is 5100. Means stereo means we can see in 3D. That's the reason the cost has been increased. Ortho corrected, again, they are raising little bit cost. Okay, like this, assume if you are university, university people, maybe they want to save money or something like that, they will be taking the first level of data, they themselves, some JRF or research fellow will be doing the advanced processing. At that time, they will be taking this particular first level of data. But for you people, we don't want to do all that particular pre-processing things. So, we will directly take the ortho data and start our project. So, that it will reduce lot of time. Yeah, you can see same ortho corrected data is there for list for MX multispectral, like ortho correct is 10,000 per scene, like that. Okay, so this rate list will be there, but don't worry, for you people the rates may not be there, okay, because it is intergovernment only. Yeah, now coming to actual presentation. Okay, so my particular presentation will be in this fashion: what is digital image, okay, followed by pre-processing things. And don't worry, all these things you people are not supposed to do. We will do and give it to you. But just for the sake of completing this particular course, I am just telling you. Okay. And ultimately, if you really want data, what we will be doing is we will process and give the precision product to you so that you can jump start to the project. Yeah. So in that way, those pre-processing usually will be radiometric correction, geometric correction, and image preparation. Okay, and anyway, image preparation sometimes you people have to do. I will just tell what are those image preparation. Like if we just assume I fallen down, some problem happened to my leg, I went to orthopedic, he told go for x-ray. Yeah, I went for x-ray, he has given some film, doctor will just put a light and on that he will see. That is not actually digital processing, digital image processing. Okay, it comes under medical imaging, but that is medical image interpretation. By seeing that, he will tell, do mahina rest lelo bhaiya, like that. Okay. Whereas in that medical imaging, lot of things may not require any sort of pre-processing. Directly we can observe. But sometimes EMR, such type, electronic magnetic resonance spectroscopy, such type of things may require some sort of processing, which will be dealt by the instrument, medical instrument itself. Okay. Whereas for us, we have to do such type of pre-processing in remote sensing data, pertaining to remote sensing data. And to see that particular data, we have to enhance also. Sometimes some dark feature will be there, or some something will be hidden under shadow. Those things we can see using image enhancements. Again, spatial filtering, image classification, all these things will be there. We will try to understand what these terms are. Okay. Now, image, we know everything image, okay, usually in previous generations also, like prehistoric age, those people used to draw the diagrams in the caves with some, like Ajanta caves, okay, age old paintings are still there. Those things we can say it as an image, it's a representation of an object, representation of object. Selfie is a digital image, because whatever the photograph we are taking, it will be stored in the form of a digital image. Okay, but whereas analog image, like earlier days, whatever the photo cameras are there, those things we can consider as analog imagery. Okay, so whatever the data is stored in the form of binary digits, that is digital image. That's it, simple. Okay, best example is this lady is taking selfie, you know, like that. So in analog images, whatever I underline, just concentrate there. Remaining things are very simple. Objects reflecting more energy. In paper, assume if it is reflecting more energy, it indicates it's a brighter. Otherwise, it is a darker. Whereas in a digital image, usually in digital image, as earlier in the morning ma'am told, everything is stored in the form of a pixel picture element. Okay, so every pixel will be having a number. Assume if it is a 8-bit image, the values will range from 0 to 255. If it is medium brightness, it is 125, just assume 125. If it is a darker pixel, it will be 0, otherwise it will be 255. If it is pure white, it will be 255. Okay, that's what it is telling. An object reflecting more energy records a higher number for itself on the digital image, and vice versa. Like, assume just background, I kept a small zoomed version of image. Don't feel panic. What is that image? Just to try to understand. Here, I highlighted something. 100! Because in entire image, that is exhibiting more whiteness. So, that is the maximum value. Similarly, you can see this particular chaya, in the sense shadow region. Those values are ranging between 22, 23, 24 like that. Because it is darker, sir. Otherwise, it is ranging high. And some values which are medium gray are executing a values of 46, 47 in that fashion, okay. So, two types of television used to be there. I think some people may not be there in that generation. I think all are maybe knowing CRT. Now, we are having LED TVs, plasma TVs, LCD TVs, but earlier we used to have simple televisions containing CRT. During those days, some TVs used to get by 6000, 7000 black and white TVs. Some TVs are little bit high value, color TVs. Because in color TV, he has to put three guns, red gun, blue gun, green gun, cathode red tube we used to call. Whereas in simple black and white TV, only one gun, which will radiate the energy from 0 to 250, voltage only, it is a voltage. Higher the voltage, brighter, less the voltage, darker. Okay. So, in the same fashion, if it is a black and white TV, only one band will be there, one band. If it is a color image, it will be three bands, which will be like one for red, one for green in that fashion. Okay, like you can see, the brightness variation is in this fashion, 0 for the dark, followed by slowly the gray values are getting increased, 255 is the maximum. This is for 8-bit image, okay. If it is 16-bit image, it will be from 0 to 64,000, okay. And usually image means it will be in this fashion only, sir. Like you can see 10, 15, 17, it is a grid containing a numeric values, that is it. It is not a high-tech this thing. And you can see this is a monochrome image, that is why it is appearing in black and white, okay. But you see this fellow, this particular sensor is having four cameras. One is blue, green, red, followed by other camera. You concentrate on this particular sensor. Say this may be multispectral camera containing four bands. So, obviously, once captured, it will have four spectral bands. Okay, say 1, 2, 3, 4. So, such type of imagery we used to call multispectral remote sensing image. Okay, usually in earlier one, it will have only column and row. Now, because the four bands are there, in order to identify a pixel, we have to tell band number also. That is why a pixel is referred by its column, row, band number. I underline the band number. Okay. So, it is like this. So, one camera will be capturing the image in say blue band, particular wavelength. Similarly, band 2, band 3, red band, and fourth band is NIR. You can see NIR is capturing a different information. So, all these images, we used to call it as band, because four bands are there, okay. And in order to organize them as a single image, if it is a single band, that is a pure image, nothing like that. But if we are having four bands, there should be some way to organize them, right? How? So, the modes are band sequential, means one band I will put, the other band under that I will put, third band I will be putting under that, like that. The other one is band interleave by line. We will do one thing to understand this, we will just see some sort of animation. So, this animation, if you see, he is writing the file in a fashion such that first band completely written, second band written, third band written, like that. Whereas, band interleaved by line, one line from first band, second line from second band in that fashion, okay. Whereas, yeah, let it complete. In that fashion, he will write entire image, one line from each band, okay. Similarly, sometimes he will write a single pixel from independent band, okay. You can see one red band is taking one pixel, green band is taking, and he fill the entire image, okay. This is just a mode how it will deliver the image. But usually, you people may be heard when we are working in internet, when we are saving some images, it will say JPEG image, GIF image, PNG image. In the same fashion, all the remote sensing imagery we usually save, we will be saving in GeoTIFF. Okay. So, when you people are expecting data from NRSA, we used to supply that in the form of GeoTIFF. Even if you are scanning some sort of documents in HP scanner, A4 scanner, it used to ask, do you want to save in a TIFF? That is a TIFF is a format, tagged image file format, TIFF. And when we are adding geographic information to it, it is nothing but GeoTIFF. GeoTIFF means, geographic means nothing but latitude, longitude information. Okay. But sometimes we used to supply some scientific data also, which will be given in this fashion, like HDF, NetCDF, don't worry, then don't feel panic. They are like higher versions of data dissemination thing. Okay. And usually this GeoTIFF also we can use, like if you see Microsoft Word, if you save it will be .doc, mm-hmm. PowerPoint it will save, it will say .ppt, mm-hmm. in the same fashion TIFF is also .tiff, mm-hmm. okay. So, this format is now public domain, it's not, it won't belong to any public company, I mean it won't belong to private company. Now, image processing means now you can say in simple word nothing but we are processing something by taking the image, but technically we used to call in this fashion. Digital image processing can be defined as the computer manipulation of digital values contained in an image for the purpose of image correction, means some correction is required, what is that we will see, and enhancement, some enhancement is required, what is that and why, we will see, and future extraction, means extract something from the image, like the doctor told na, haan bhaiya do mahina le lo, because uska thoda sa damage jyada ho gaya, haddi jyada toot gaya, usiliye bola tha. Like that we are extracting some information from the imagery, okay, whereas for you people is nothing but medicinal plant information, obviously, yeah. And usually this particular system consists of some hardware, computers, all this stuff, we will see those things. So, I think already you people are having in our lab that are being maintained by FIAS. Usually, we used to supply data in the form of FTP server or CDs or DVDs or even some hard disk, portable hard disk. Okay, if you ask data from NRSC, we used to send in that fashion. So, before processing them, you people usually copy into the data into local disk of that particular thing. So, that is nothing but a host computer. And this host computer, we used to have digital image processing software. And primarily, it should have a monitor, high-end monitor. Then only we will able to see the imagery. Okay, and this image processor usually should support zooming, zoom out, panning. If it is a 3D, it will have a tilting also, so that we can see the terrains, undulations, all this stuff. And after all, we have to take printouts also sometimes in the form of maps, naksha, all these things. Those things will be in this fashion output plotter, or sometimes we will be saving, after doing some manipulation, we will save it into a disk, local disk. Simple, nothing. Okay. So, to support this, such type of peripherals are required. You know this, all these things, no issues. Okay. Like scanner or digital camera or host computer, desk edge printer or plotter. And main thing is the workstation. Now, coming to the color theory, you may be knowing we are having three primary colors, RGB, red, green and blue. From these colors only we used to derive the remaining secondary colors. Usually by the fusing red and green we used to get yellow color. Okay. Similarly, red and blue will be giving magenta and green and blue will be giving cyan. If we mix all the three colors, it will be white color. Okay. So, some theory is explaining, but the fundamental thing is this one only. Okay. And he is telling in this cube that everything starts from black and ends with white. The means fusing of all the colors will be white. If you can see, like here red is there, here green is there, blue is there. And blue and green, we will be getting this thing, cyan followed by red and green, when they are going, they are converging towards yellow. Okay, when all the three colors are fusing, we are getting white in that fashion. This is simple color theory. Whatever we thought about CRT, you know, cathode ray tube, just 5 minutes back, the same thing. Okay, and again, we can do some sort of combination of these particular bands also. Assume, see, NIR image we cannot see now. Naked eye will be seeing from only the visible spectra. and in near infrared eye will not able to see, but sensor will capture some information. Those information in order to see, we will be putting in such a way that in red band I will be putting NIR, and red band will be shifted to green, green will be shifted to blue. That's what known as false color composition. That false, the word false is coming in that fashion. The reverse is natural color composite. Natural color composite is the one which we will see by nature. I think probably you people may saw in Bhuvan or Google Earth, whatever you are seeing is nothing but natural color composite. Okay. So, these are the system functionalities of image processing. It starts from data acquisition or restoration. Once we acquire the data, as such we cannot use it. Some sort of remedies has to be done. Usually there are two types of operations. One is radiometric operation and the other one is a geometric correction. Okay. Then image enhancement. Just like that we cannot do any interpretation. It has to be enhanced. Okay. And information extraction followed by some other miscellaneous information like photogrammetric information extraction, metadata, lineage documentation, all this information. The added information, this is just like date, when it was acquired, time, where, at what time it is acquired, all this stuff. And assume even the sun angle of acquisition, all these things will be recorded here. Okay. Now, commercially we are having some famous software. One is this one from Hexagon, Eridas Imagine. The other one is Rolta, from this company Rolta. They are having Rolta Geomatica suit followed by Geospatial NV. Already we are having NV, don't worry. In medicinal plants board we are having NV, okay, for scientific operations. The advantage is we can pay some sort of amount, and regularly we used to get some updates. Okay, that is known as AMC, but cost may be little bit higher, but operational projects, it's not a big issue. There is one particular site known as UN Spider. It's it want to help all the scientific community, sir. This particular portal gives good information about all the available software pertaining to remote sensing and GIS. I request you please note it down, United Nations Spider. Okay. United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs is telling space based information for disaster management and emergency response. Like Haiti earthquake happened some 6-7 years back. I think Haiti is the, Haiti, correct. Large scale devastation happened there. At that time, this UN Spider has been originated. So, it told to all the space agencies, please give available data like that. Please give some free software so that we will process and help the society. So, like this, this UN Spider has been originated. It gives a comprehensive listing of available software. Like I just, you can see it is like this, software name, what is the purpose of software? You are able to see, na?
Yeah.
And Lelji, you are able to see, na? And it is telling whether it is free or free of cost, like that. Okay. And which company or which platform it will be working. I just marked some one or two. One is BEAM software from European Space Agency. It is free. Similarly, one is BEAT. It is also from European Space Agency, ESA. It was written ESA. Okay. It is also free. So, anybody can download them and use it. But only thing is we have to learn, but don't worry, every software will be having a forum. We can write a query, boss, how to use this software, then 100 people will give a response. So, it will be easy and fun. Yeah, even NV is also listed, you can see. NV, it is telling free to try, means it is a cost, it is a cost. But for 15 days or 30 days, we can use it, no harm. Similarly, Eridas Imagine from Intergraph company is telling free to try. Okay. So, a comprehensive list will be available, and not only these things, sir, you can see, like you can just see flow fit, flow R, yeah, flow R means flow path assessment of gravitational hazards at regional level, something like that. So, it will have almost some 200 listing of software. Maybe probably some medicinal plant information may be there, we just explore. And similarly, some other remote sensing or image processing software like these things are known as FOSS, free and open source software. Even we can not only the software, but source code can also be downloaded. And if any software developer is there, you can tell, boss, please this modify this and put our algorithm like that. But only thing is we have to give it back. So in that category, we are having Beam software from ESA and ILVIS software from ITC Netherlands and Monterey from this is actually French like ISRO India, NASA US, CNES is for France. Okay, they developed the software and given as a free to the community. Similarly, Optics, a group of scientists gathered and incorporated all the algorithms pertaining to image processing and kept in the Optics. And like one more thing is Map Window. Okay, all these things we can download and work it for free, no harm. But all these particular software will be using a core image processing library called GDAL. Okay, so this GDAL will be having number of functionalities, ready-made functionalities. Whatever the free software we discussed just now or commercial software we discussed just now will be using directly or indirectly this GDAL. Okay, and it is now abbreviated in this fashion. GDAL stands for Geospatial Data Abstraction Library. Don't worry, this GDAL is having one more sister known as OGR. This will be supporting vectors. Usually GIS software will play with vector and image processing will be playing with raster. Okay, so this GDAL library will be having lot of free functionalities. You can do some scientific computing or implement advanced algorithms using this GDAL. It's also free of cost. Not only that, even NRSA developed one particular image processing software. This is from NRSA site itself, www.nrsa.gov.in download section, download software. We can click here and download this PrimeBeam software and do whatever the image processing steps we want. Okay. Don't worry, even if you people want some customized package, we will do it free of cost. Not only NRSA, even you can associate with IARS also, because it's close now from Delhi to this thing. So you have to tell, sir, this is my requirement, please develop. So we are having very good pool of developers. They will develop that particular software and give it to you. Okay. So, for example, let me show you a small software which we developed. One particular mega project is there known as Land Use Land Cover 250,000 scale. The problem with them is every day they have to acquire the data. They have to do the land use map by taking Kharif, Rabi and Jayid crop. Okay. So, they used to take the data, some 40-50 people used to sit and do it. It used to take some 30-40 days for processing 1 month data. By the end, they have to process Kharif, but Rabi used to start. So, a lot of problems used to happen. Now, if you see this particular software we developed for them, whatever NDC delivers the data in the form of a zip file, which will contain the TIFF files, will be checked whether entire data is there or not, then followed by whether metadata is there or not, it will check and start the ortho generation process. Take this particular word granted, ortho generation. And with the help of some elevation data, it will do some processing, like whatever the errors are there, it will be nullified. Okay, and then top of atmosphere computation will be done. Don't worry, these are little bit scientific words, but ultimately it will be given to the user agency. And everything will be over within say some 12 hours. Earlier it used to be 6 months of time, but within 12 hours, half of the day we used to complete this. Okay, the same screenshot I kept, like assume today 15 scenes we got it. Okay, fatafat it is processing, 15:03 it is over, 15:05 2 minutes like that. Okay, everything automatic, no man required. So such type of things also we used to do. Okay. So basically, for remote sensing is not a simple ideal or it will not work as anticipated, because a lot of errors will be induced. This is because, see, Earth is rotating, okay, and platform is also moving, whatever the satellite is there, and it will move in three fashions. First of all, it is moving in this fashion, it may move in this fashion also, we don't know. And the main enemy for remote sensing is atmosphere. The molecules that are present in the atmosphere will induce lot of error. Okay, because of that, whatever the sensor has to record, it will record with some anomalies. We have to remove those anomalies. That is nothing but radiometric correction. And because of earth rotation or platform instability, some other error will be induced. That is nothing but geometric error. We'll see how to remove those two things. Radiometric and geometric correction of remotely sensitive data are normally referred to as pre-processing operations. So before doing any mapping, first of all, these two things has to be completed. Okay. So image pre-processing hopefully produces a correct image that is as close as possible, but radiometrically and geometrically to the true radiant energy and spatial characteristics of study area at the time of data collection. You can see it's an illustrative diagram. The basis of remote sensing, as you know, it's nothing but a sun. Sun should be present, otherwise in dark nothing we can see. Whatever the rays that are coming, first of all it has to travel or it has to touch the terrain or ground. That itself will be having lot of interaction with the atmosphere. Scattering, me scattering, Rayleigh scattering will be happening with the molecules that are present in the atmosphere. So the rays will interact, there itself some sort of disturbance will occur. And then it will hit the ground, those rays, there again absorption, transmission and reflection will be happening. Whatever the reflected rays are there, only those things will be going to the satellite or say sensor. Again those rays will be interacting with the atmosphere. Okay. And not only those rays which are interacting with the ground, surrounding rays will also creep into the sensor. So like this, the abnormalities will be entering into the imagery and corrupt the radiometry of the data. Okay. So what we will be doing anyway, I'll just proceed to the next. These are some sample examples of radiometric problems. Like one is, you can see this image, it's having some erratic stripes. This fellow, you see carefully, suddenly one detector failed because we don't know. Okay, some strange lines came. Here also, strangely this few lines came into picture. Okay. So, to be frank, we can't do anything. What we will do in this situation is, we will be taking an average of upper line and lower line. It's like a cosmetic this thing. If we are having some pimple, we will do some, or we will add some extra fair and lowly on that, something like that. Okay. And similarly, atmospheric correction. Because of atmosphere, lot of corruption or induced anomalies came into the picture. Those things we will apply this atmospheric correction. You can see difference, right? Yeah. Before fair and lovely, after fair and lovely, like that. Yeah. And some other things like sun angle correction. Assume throughout the year we are collecting the data, but sun is not constant in the sense sometimes in summer sun will be at this position, in rainy season it will be in this position, in winter dup thoda kam hota hai na. So but we will rationalize it. We will rationalize it and segregate if we are doing year wise analysis. And this is one more, topographic correction. Okay, assume salt forest is there on the northern side as well as south side. Say this south side we are having shadow during the 10:30. Okay, so because of that the signature varies little bit. The pixel values will be in the downer side, in the sense 50 like that. Whereas same here it will be 100 like that because of brightness. Okay, so those corrections will also be done. Coming to the geometric correction. See, actually, in order to understand this one, it's very simple. If you are telling a building should be in this particular latitude, longitude, it should be there only. It should not go, or if you are mapping, India boundary will be there. It should fix in the inside that particular boundary. It should not go beyond the Indian boundary. Okay, that is what geometry of the imagery. Because this particular errors will be caused because of this one, motion of the platform, the sensor itself is moving, or rotation of the earth, or even terrain effects. We will see in a pictorial form. Ultimately, what we have to do is, we have to remove this particular errors so that a map-like information should be retrieved from this data. That is nothing but a planimetric map. Then only precise measurements can be taken. Otherwise, whatever the area we are computing from the data, we'll be having some errors. Okay. So, three things will be there. One is geocoding or georeferencing. The other one is rectification. Other one is registration. Registration will come. If already some good image is there. The input image, whatever we got, should exactly sit on that. So, that is what we used to call register with respect to other image. Okay. Then the next one is rectification. It is nothing but a, we used to say rectify it, means remove the error. Okay. Because we have to make it into a planimetric map. And the first one is geocoding or georeferencing, both are same words. Nothing but in a ordinary raw image, we are putting geographic information. The process is known as this thing, georeferencing. What is this symbol of love? Blunder. It is known as Bibi Ka Maqbara, located, see, you people don't, that is not georeferenced. No, it is georeferenced. This fellow is somewhere in Aurangabad, Maharashtra. Okay, so let us see actual Taj Mahal. This is Bangladesh Taj Mahal, sir, not Indian. Okay, it is lying in Bangladesh Taj Mahal, a scaled copy of original Taj Mahal. So, you can see, we can see how important this georeferencing is. Just by seeing this piece, sir, ye to Kerala ka hai. No, no, no. It may be in Manasarovar. That is the reason georeferencing is very important. Okay, now I will not play any games. This is our actual Taj Mahal. Okay. Piche hai na, Yamuna River hai, that garden is there. And let me furthermore zoom. Actually, that person planned for one more Taj Mahal, that is Black Taj. Yes. Okay, you can see here, this is White Taj, and in front of that he made all these fountains and this thing. And peeche dekhiye, Yamuna River hai, Yamuna River ke baaju mein, this particular structure. He tried or he kept that as a foundation for Black Taj, but paisa khatam ho gaya, khajana kali. Okay, and even his sons become enemies, no? Then in the same fashion, wo pura kar diya, matlab, you can see here, he made all the foundation, but uska wo age bhi thoda sa, matlab, budapa aa gaya, all this stuff, okay. And it is there in the Taj, Agra, that is what georeference means. So, whatever analysis we will be doing, first of all, this georeference is a must. Backside you are seeing Indian boundary, and front you are seeing that particular image. So, don't worry, we, NRSA will do all this image processing and supply to you people. Now, it is on you, what research you people will be doing with the data. So, this much story we will be, entire very good team will be doing, okay, and give it to you, quality, by giving assurance of quality. And sometimes you people may be having some legacy data, and or you want to do on your own. At the time, we have to do this georeferencing. The best source of ground control point is topo sheet, Survey of India topo sheet. Because this again, Survey of India topo sheet, by paying 25 rupees, something like that, we can purchase from Survey of India office. We will be scanning and doing one operation known as georeferencing again. Okay. You can see here. Whatever the grid interval is there, from there we can take the latitude, longitude, and give the GCP there, and do the, apply the transformation. Then it will be converted into digital georeferenced image. From paper, it will be converted into digital georeferenced image. Now, that image is there. That image, with the help of the incoming image, both can be used to take the GCPs and apply the transformation. It's nothing but image to image referencing. Okay. This is a small example how we will be taking GCPs. Usually you can see here that person has concentrated on junctions of road. Okay. Even the river is there, is not taking any point on river, because river stream will be changing. Okay. Whereas road junctions, corner of the buildings will not be changed. So such type, or it should, the point should not be underneath a tree. These simple rules are there for a ground control point. Usually the other thing is GPS survey. We will be taking our GPS receiver, go for survey, take what is the latitude, longitude, again come back to the lab and apply the GCP in the image. Okay. And again, when we are telling this GCP, we usually use the GPS receiver. GPS is nothing as a generic term, global position system. It is actually released by United States, I will say, with the constellation of 24 satellites, but there are actually 32. 24 will be operating at one go. They kept the constellation such that at any point of time, we will able to see minimum 12 satellites. Okay, and those 12 satellites, we will get the signal, the receiver will compute the latitude longitude on the ground. That particular latitude longitude will be putting as a GCP in the image. Okay. Let me show this one. Actually, that particular GPS system is called as Navstar. But we don't know when US people will stop their services. We will be in problems. That is the reason our Gagan has been developed, and even our own constellation of softwares are GPS is there, IRNSS. Okay, we can consider that GCPs from even Gagan based survey, or some other countries are also having their own GPS constellation, like Russian GLONASS, China BeiDou, Galileo for IRNS, and for India dedicatedly we are having IRNSS, or as Prime Minister told, we can nomenclature as NAVIC. Okay. See, this Gagan actually will be using that GPS constellation, as well as it will have its own two GSAT satellites. They will be doing some correction and giving to the user. Okay. Those things are known as SBAS, Satellite Based Augmenting System. Okay. So, in future, we may able to use this IRNS GPS survey. So, this is a sample of Gagan receiver. Because whatever the receiver we are having in our mobile phones, usually it is GPS, US GPS based. Now, to do survey, we can request NRSA to get a Gagan USB dongle, or even this one, Bluetooth device also we can do. Okay. But I don't think you people will be requesting for raw data, you will be requesting for some precision data. Okay. Like assume one image, assume if already. Or sometimes what happens, we may get data from external sources, free data. Okay, some university kept in their website, we will able to take those things. In that we are discussing these things. If it is from NRSA, don't worry, we will give the precision product. But if you are getting from external agency, assume Botanical Survey of India given bus, you do or whatever you want, BSI. Then such type of things may come. So, for that what we have to do is, with the help of input image, you tell this point is equal to this point, this point is equal to this point, this green point equal to green point, like that. Few GCPs will be taken and apply that transformation. Then that image and this image will be co-registered, like that. Okay, as an example, you see, in this image, he has taken this point and this point. Okay, and this image, this point is equal to this point, like that he applied. Then he applied the transformation. This fellow is sitting nicely inside this one. Okay. So, during this process, it has done some rotation operation, it has done some translation from there to there, and it has done a scaling also, this much image become this much. So, these three operations will be undergoing, translation, rotation and scaling. Okay. Then we used to say, both the images are co-registered. Okay. There is a small operation known as swiping to check that particular thing. Okay, we can swipe and see whether they are sitting or not. Any anomalies, like if still some shift is there, that river will not be sitting in that fashion. It will have some movement. Okay, from there we can assess the quality of geometry. Okay, but this particular ortho image is the best or precision product, which is error-free image. What happens, you just see, when we are mapping, we will be mapping such that all the rays will be perpendicular to the our eye. Then only we used to call it as a map. All the rays should be perpendicular. It should not be having any some skew error, all this stuff. Okay. Like if we are mapping a small area like chimney in the sense factories will be having that cylinder shape. No? So, if you see, it will be in this fashion. But usually in the map, we used to map only this fellow. That is a geometrically corrected one. Similarly, in the imagery, you can see we will be mapping in this fashion. There is a building. But we will not say this entire thing is a building. We will not say like this. So, the precision product will be in this fashion. See, we are seeing only the top. That is what ortho image. During the course of this ortho image, we have to use some digital elevation model. Digital elevation model is nothing but two types are there. One is bare earth model, only earth. The other one is DSM, digital surface model, which will be having man-made buildings and all these things. These things, see, for example, to do this ortho image correction, for this image, we have to use the DSM. That building is also has to be considered. Okay, then only that error will be nullified. And even for this particular DEM, we are having a special sensor called CartoSat data, where it will have two sensors. It is like this, when it is going, first image will be taken, after some 52 seconds gap, the second image will be taken. These two images will be acting like an eyes, left eye, right eye. So, when we are seeing with a stereo, the depth will be perceived. That is nothing but the distance. That is nothing but a 3D. Okay. Other example I will, in order to explain, you can see cow, horse, they are not wild, no? Because they will not have any 3D. Human, tigers, they know how to attack because we are seeing this thing in a 3D fashion. That is the best example to understand. Okay. Now, that particular elevation will be used to and process or used for generation the ortho image. Okay. So, here you can see just reading that one. Because of the orthographic property, ortho image can be used like a map for measurement of distance, angles, areas, etc. Then the precise mensuration can be done. Okay. So, these are all the pre-processing and I am assuring we will do and supply to you, but just for the sake of completing this particular training, I am telling to you. Okay. And from your side, you may have to do such type of things. Once if we are giving in GeoTIFF, GeoTIFF can be opened in any image processing software. If you are asking data in some other fashion, you have to do that import business. Means from one format to other format, you have to import it. Okay. The other one is subsetting. See, we will be giving full area. You may be concentrating only on one or two ranges. So, you will subset it. You will cut it. Subset will be two types. One is area subset. One is band subset. Out of four bands, you may want to use only red band. So, one band only you will use, two subsets. Mosaicing, we will be giving a scene only. Sometimes you people may ask, no, I want entire forest. Then what we will do, we will mosaic the individual scene and supply to you people. Like an example, you can see, this is one scene, this is the second scene, third scene, four, five and small sixth one. But when we are giving a single image, or you people can also do this particular operation in image processing software, and a single image can be generated. In that our research, assume that is our area of interest, study area. Okay, that mosaic can be made, and from there we can start our research. Similarly, layer stacking. Sometimes red layer is there, blue layer is there, green layer is there. We have to make it as image. That stacking we can make, that is layer stacking reprojection. Usually data will be in geographic coordinate system, we can make it into other projections also. See, from three dimensional, Earth is a 3D na, globe, from that we have to make it into a 2D form of thing, that is known as projection. Okay. Then pan sharpening. See, one particular thing, usually we are having sensors which will generate image in with high resolution but monochrome, black and white information. And other information will be in multispectral, but with a lower resolution. So, I can generate that particular or fuse both these particular images. Okay. Let me tell you a small example. Yeah, don't worry. Like you can see, LIS-4 is having 5.6 meters data. The clarity is little bit less, whereas CartoSat is having high spatial information because it is 2.5 meter, but it is not having any color information. Okay, I can fuse both this particular data to create such type of scintillating effect. Then our interpretation can start. That is nothing but pan sharpening, or in other words, image fusion. Okay. Conditions apply. What is that? Both these images should be sub-pixel level co-registration should happen. Otherwise, disaster will happen. Why? From that information, just assume here this bridge is there. When they are not co-registered, then it will appear such that two bridges are there. One here bridge, other one is one more bridge. So, So those are very disaster. So first of all, both these things too should have a subpixel registration. One is to other relation should be there. Okay. And coming to image enhancement, see, lot of techniques will be there. Just like that, we may not able to see the raw image. Some sort of enhancements has to be carried. Like an example, okay, don't worry, because I am giving these slides, I will be little bit faster. A lot of information is visible in this image, right? Nothing is visible because some sort of enhancement, only some small this thing is visible. So what to do? Okay, so we have to do some abracadabra, then we will able to see. You can see Subhanchal Girls Hostel, Raj Sabhavas INA and Block B. Okay, means some enhancement has done, sir. Enhancement has been done. Okay, so what enhancement, what is that abracadabra? Is this one. Earlier in the raw image, all the pixels are from 0 to say some 80. Those things I stretched it from 0 to 255 levels, then the information started coming. Okay, you are seeing towards girls hostel, be careful. Okay. So, the same sort of enhancements can be done in multispectral images also. Okay, no, nothing special techniques required. This is a small example to understand the histogram. Okay, usually see dark image entirely it is in this fashion. Whereas in the this brighter image, okay, here all the pixels are towards say from 125 to 255, and this one only middle gray levels are coming, and this is perfect. Lot of information is visible because the values are stretched from 0 to 255. Okay, so two types of stretches will be there. One is linear and other is non-linear. In linear, all the values, assume the input image is having values from 84 to 153, it will be enlarged to 0 to 255. In non-linear, what we will do, assume is telling one example nicely, okay. Assume we are having values from say just 80 to 90, only those parts will be enlarged, remaining I will forget, okay. Assume I am interested only in enhancing the values pertaining to this river, so that I can see the sedimentation value. So I know the values are from say 40 to 76, so only those values I will be doing the stretching. Remaining values like all 0 to okay, remaining values will be nullified. Okay, so those things which I want to concentrate, those features can be highlighted. Okay, then comes the filtering. See, filtering simple, low pass filter, high pass filter. Already you people may heard these two things. No? Low pass filtering means low frequency values will be passed, high pass will be high pass, frequency will be stopped like that. In other sense, this particular low pass filter is highly useful for noise removals. Okay, or in other sense, we can use for smoothing this imagery. Okay, what is the smoothing? We will see illustrative fashion. And in high pass filter, which we will use for sharpen the image, that is for smoothing. This is for sharpen, and similarly other operations includes edge detectors. Okay, we will see in pictorial form. Like you can see here, original image is in this fashion. When I apply the low pass filter is nothing but a matrix, sir. We will multiply that image with the matrix. Then you can see the original image, if we are doing the low pass filter, it is a little bit smoothened. If we apply with a high pass filter matrix, the features are sharpened. Both images are actually same, but after applying that particular matrix, lot of information is retrieved here. It depends on our research whether what filter has to be applied. When we want to sharpen it, apply with the high pass filter. When we want to smoothen it, apply the low pass filter. In the same fashion, we can apply some edge detectors also. Given an urban scene, you can see lot of literature is available, and lot of mechanisms are there to generate the edges. Okay, what is the use of these edges? I will tell you in a short this thing after some time. And I observed, you people may ask, sir, which is the best edge detector or which is the best matrix like that. Universally, there is no single detector, sir. And I saw number of investigators usually do all the available edge detectors, but they will compare in this fashion, which is one like that. Then finally they will tell, hey, Chris model is very good, this model is retrieving very good information, baki sab chodke they will be concentrating only like that. So in our research also, usually it is always better to do all the available operations and get the best one. Yeah, that process, edge detection process is a part of segmentation. We will come to the segmentation in few minutes. Now comes the classification. Okay. So classification, it's like this. A human being is standing in this fashion. I will tell, two hands classified as two hands, two legs, stomach part and face part. So I am classified in this fashion. So given an image, I want to classify it. This is forest, this is agriculture, this is river, this is urban, like that. That is what classifying the image. Okay. Two types of methods are there. One is supervised, one is unsupervised. You know, the simple manner in unsupervised means nobody is there to supervise. That's it. No? So we will tell to computer, you do here some 10 classes, you divide it. So computer will be having some algorithm. It will generate some 10 classes. Whereas supervised, we will go to the field. We will see, achha, a dark black material and feed it there. Or say some crop, this is maize crop, this is paddy crop, we will take the signature and feed it into the system. Then it accordingly it will do the classification. Okay. That is what I is telling, unsupervised classification, supervised classification. Okay. Only thing in unsupervised classification is we have to tell how many classes, 100, 20, 30, like that. Then accordingly that particular algorithm will divide the whole image into that many parts. Okay. But usually for higher resolution imagery, we are not supposed to use classification, we will be using segmentations. Okay. Anyway, this is one illustrative example. Here what he is doing, he collected signature, cotton followed by alpha alpha, grass, like that. Then the actual supervised algorithm will be ran. Then object-oriented classification is a recent technique, because nowadays we are flooded with number of high-resolution satellites. This segmentation, this classification will not be working on them. Okay, because the clarity of information has increased nowadays using this high-resolution data like Cartosat or QuickBird. Okay, so what they are telling is object-oriented classification technique allows the analyst to decompose the scene into many relatively homogeneous objects. Like assume if you are having an urban city, we will be having buildings like houses. Houses will be small rectangles or squares. Shopping malls will be bigger rectangles. Okay, roads will be say some rectangle, big rectangle sort of thing. Like that we can segment the entire image. Then we can tell if this square is of this much square area, this is a house. If this is bigger and irregular pattern, then it is a shopping mall. If it is a rectangle and having this sort of gray value, then it is a road. And if the width of the rectangle is more, then it is some national highway passing. Such type of things we can do. That is known as segmentation or object-oriented classification. Okay. And one more image processing is this fellow, change detection. You can see 1994 and 1996, lot of change is there. Okay, that lake, because they kept the restriction, no, don't enter lake. But that real estaters, lake ko chodke bana diya. And he will tell, lake view apartment, because lake hai na, like the development happened. So we can apply the change detection. Okay. And finally comes to the map making. That is our ambition, no, sir. All this processing we done because to make a map. And you know, whenever naksha hai, all these elements should be there. Map body, whatever the content is there, that itself is map body. Followed by one title should be there. Kya naksha hai ye? Okay. Kajana, hedarai, something will be there. No? Then legend, scale, data source, all these things will be there. If it is not a map, somewhere we will be embedding in a report or through web, all these things we have to, or it has to disseminate. Naksha banao, jeb mein rakho, matlab, nahi chalega. It is useless. Okay, it has to put into some web or somewhere. Or it can go to some decision support system or further analysis. Okay. So, for this purpose, for dissemination purpose, we use web mapping. Separate class is there for web mapping. I am just giving a touch up for this. Okay. In a simple internet, whenever we are typing www.google.com, it will go to the Google server. But any server will able to showcase only two information. One is textual data, other one is small GIF files or PNG files. That's it. But our remote sensing data usually contains bigger images like GeoTIFF or vector data. These things internet cannot show. So what we have to do is, you can see this particular example, a user, P, user through Internet Explorer or Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox will ask www.yahoo.com, www.rediff.com, then the site has to come. It will just, internet connection should be there. It will just go and hit the web server, Rediff server, Yahoo server, Google server, and bring the page and show to you in the form of HTML. And HTML is in the form of textual or some small images in the fashion GIF or JPEG. Whereas we used to put all the imagery or vector data in GIS server. This information has to be ported to web server. Then the application server will help us in converting into HTML format. Sweta, you got it, na? All the data usually we will be putting in GIS server. That data with the help of GIS server will be converted into HTML format. That HTML will be served to the user. Simple. Okay. So, don't worry. Again, one more session is there. And because you people are here, once you want to disseminate the data, it has to kept in some domain. ISRO is helping us to put this data in domain. Usually, we have to depend on NIC. And again, NIC people will come, boss, this much budget, this much data, all these things. Whereas ISRO will do free service for this. You just give the data, we will host it using Bhuvan. Using Bhuvan. So, Bhuvan web portal is in this fashion. And you can see e-governance dashboard is there. For a lot of government agencies, we are developing free portals. Examples. And let me re-emphasize, Bhuvan itself is a viewer. Like Google Earth, we can see entire globe or in a 2D fashion. And at the same time, we will develop applications for other ministries also. As an example, we developed one portal for Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So, you can see all the image by clicking here, we can see that particular data. Similarly, disaster service, National Disaster Emergency Management for Public, we can see crowdsourced data. I think Bihar floods, he want to show something like that. Similarly, island information system, okay, it may not be for some ministry, but it may be for some university. We will do and put it in the public and we will give this link. This link you can use for our clients. Okay. Similarly, for Ministry of Environment, we are doing some query shell. See, what he want? Distribution of flycatchers. This is one application. So, here we can tell where is the cited location equal to Catcher Hills. So, by this is a query and we can say query, we can click this query. Wherever that flycatchers are cited, that point is visible here. Okay. So, such type of dissemination mechanism also ISRO will help. So, I covered from how we will acquire the data, how we will give the data to you people and what in between we will be doing and what you people has to do investigation and after investigation where the data should go, should be to the public through Bhuvan sort of websites. Thank you.